Hello everyone and welcome to this new CUBE conversation. My name is Christophe Bertrand, Principal Analyst here at theCUBE Research. I'm joined today by Sazzala Reddy, who is the VP of VMware, Cloud Storage and Data at Broadcom. Lots of big responsibilities. Welcome to theCUBE, it's great to have you here. It's not your first time, you're a CUBE alum. But remind us about what you do today at Broadcom.
Hey Christophe. Yes, I'm the VMware Cloud CTO for storage and for data. And mostly I focus on building storage products and also in cyber resiliency and cyber recovery products. I've been doing this for some time in my career, so this is kind of what I like to do.
Yes, and we've known each other for a few years and I certainly know you from the past in other functions, and you certainly know quite a bit about this topic. And it's an important topic because truly cyber resiliency, although it seems like a new term, is really where the market is today. What I've observed as an analyst is really the evolution of traditional disaster recovery, literally merging into cybersecurity, colliding with a lot of various components. But in order to be successful, what is critical is to have a very strong infrastructure foundation, because that has to be resilient, and then, only then can you add additional capabilities to further build the resiliency and really put organizations in a position where they can recover their systems, their data, and literally their infrastructure and their business. So let's talk a little bit about the cloud foundation components that you offer.
Yeah. So broadly speaking, VMware Cloud Foundation, VCF, it's a private cloud infrastructure. It's a cloud infrastructure, right? As a cloud infrastructure vendor, it's our responsibility. We feel obligated that we need to kind of make our cloud resilient to issues, to disasters, or for cyber crime, things like that. So broadly, we have done a few things to actually integrate a lot of these components into the infrastructure, like VCF. And just two broad pictures are, one is that how do we kind of detect and prevent and kind of look at the analysis of the data and see what's, stop before it gets too wide. And secondly is that, okay, let's say it did get infiltrated, how do we recover fast from these things? So broadly, these are the two topics we really kind of are focusing on and very well integrated into the product.
Yeah, you make a couple of very key points here. Number one is, as far as I'm concerned, it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. So of course you want to be able to recover quickly, but it's also absolutely critical to do whatever you can up front to detect and to stop the problem from happening. So there's a lot to do here, and you mentioned VMware Cloud Foundation. So what is foundational? What have you done specifically to establish this infrastructure that companies of all sizes can use? And then let's talk about how you've built on that for the recoverability of the whole infrastructure.
Yeah, so rather than me using words, let me just show you a picture and kind of some animation to actually walk you through what is the first part. How do you prevent? How do you make sure that things don't infiltrate? So I have a few slides I'll show you, walk you through it. So, mostly when we think about network intrusion, we think about things coming in from the outside, from the perimeter. But as we realize that perimeter security is not enough, a lot of traffic is going across the VMs laterally. A bulk of the data traffic is across these VMs running in your infrastructure. So how do we protect that? So typically what people generally typically do is that they try to buy all these different boxes for firewalls, for intrusion detection, for network analysis, things like that. And then the challenge is that every traffic which comes out of the VM must go through these boxes. It basically makes the whole thing slow and very complex to manage, and basically it's very costly to do as well, so which is why most people don't do it. So there is a better way to do this. It's kind of what we thought about. And how we thought about this is that instead of buying all these different systems, what if we bring all these functions, all these intrusion detection and network analysis traffic directly to where the VMs are and run it as part of your infrastructure? That's what we mean by having this as part of the infrastructure, and it's all kind of built in. It's a experience of a plug and play that you don't have to go and buy five different products. It's all built into the product. So this is the part about where we're talking about how do we make intrusion detection and network analysis be part of the built-in foundation building block for private cloud.
Right, thank you. And thank you for the pictures here, because I think it really helps understand the infrastructure you're building. So you mentioned lateral security. I think it's a very interesting term you're using here, because what you're saying is you can't just look at a silo. You have to look at it holistically. It's a full integrated stack. Yep. And by the way, I think there's a great white paper on the topic that I certainly encourage our viewers to also take a look at that covers a lot of this. And we'll talk more about this in a minute. But what's nice here is you're not looking at components that may multiply and become hard to manage. You've really unified everything in terms of the various components, everything's in a VM, the management, the plug and play. Skill sets are a big issue right now in IT. As we know, it's a big issue in cybersecurity. Nobody has a PhD in disaster recovery anymore. So you have to be able to do this in a way that is reasonably simple as an IT generalist. Now let's talk about what else you've done in terms of capabilities adding on to the Cloud Foundation to be able to position that those RPOs and RTOs you talked about, that fast recovery or recoverability.
So like we discussed, definitely we should do the prevention part of it, but clearly sometimes it escapes, people do phishing, whatever, like all these things happen. The question then becomes is that how fast can you recover from these cyber crime situations, right? And the faster you recover, the better off you are in terms of moving on with life. Otherwise you're stuck there, you're gonna have to pay the ransom, right? All that stuff. So we built something else called VLR. It's called the VMware Live Recovery. And the word is important, recovery. It's not a backup product, it's a recovery product. And the idea is that we will store a kind of a bunch of your high frequency snapshots in a place. And when there is a problem, we're able to like analyze some of these snapshots and backups and analyze hey, what is there a problem? Like all that stuff. And if there is a problem, ransomware recovery is a little different from disaster recovery. Disaster recovery is easy, hey, last time something went down, bring it up. But for ransomware, it's a iteration job. You do not know when exactly you got ransomware hit. And then the challenge is that if you just bring up your workloads in anywhere, different site, whatever it is, it'll reinfect your systems. So then you got to think about all these things. And also, there are five different pieces you got to stitch together to actually recover. You need EDR tools. Also, these days, ransomware is no longer just file-based, signature-based. It's mostly like file-less. It requires behavior analysis, next-gen antivirus things. You need networking isolation because you don't want things to escape you. So all of these things, many, many pieces, I think this is a challenge, like a DIY kit for customers. So we kind of took all these ideas and put it into like one tool, into one part of the VCF stack, and provide these wired workflows for people to recover and help customers guide through the recovery workflow so that when they get hit by ransomware, they're there feeling confident that they're not trying something for new, and there's a workflow, there's guided, you can click, and then actually guide you through the process of how to recover and then bring you back to a good, reasonable state so that you can get back to business.
Right, and you mentioned EDR type of integrations. You also integrate with a number of storage vendors and solutions, as well as backup and recovery vendors. So essentially, if you're an organization, again, what type of customers do you have? Is it mid-size? Is it large enterprise? Is it across the board?
Firstly, VMware is spread across lots of different kinds of customers, big, small, it's ubiquitous everywhere. And also ransomware is equal opportunity, it hits everybody. And we also found that we designed our system to help address thousands of VMs, or 10,000 VMs for customers. Also for customers who only have hundreds of VMs. So we kind of designed it so that it scales quite well for the different kind of customers we have across our portfolio.
Right, so that's an important point. So everybody, you're right, is potentially a target, will be a victim at some point for sure, and will need to recover. You mentioned integrations with EDR, backup recovery vendors. Let's talk about the ecosystem very briefly. What else do you do from an integration standpoint to help customers really make everything work together?
So there are three aspects to this ecosystem. Generally, VMware, from a historical perspective, has been very ecosystem-friendly, partner-friendly, because you can't build everything, we need partners, right? So the initial part of the cyber resiliency part is that we partner quite well with the EDR vendors like CrowdStrike, Carbon Black, all these other folks. And secondly, from a data protection point of view, to recover and tools like that, we have a lot of backup vendors and who actually provide backups and some tools to recover as well. Third one is that once you get hit, there's also these vendors who will provide you services to recover. They're mostly services, professional services kind of thing. So there's broad spectrum of partners. We work with all of these partners and we have a lot of APIs and generally we work with them quite well. We talk to them a lot to see how can we help them.
Well, that's great because, you know, there are so many dimensions, and really cyber resilience is teamwork. Actually, Broadcom participated in our cyber resiliency summit in the past few weeks, and certainly it was great to hear about your solutions, and definitely teamwork is the key here. So I'd like to maybe double click on a couple of aspects. You mentioned, obviously, the ability to recover faster. What's the business advantage? What do you see your customers telling you in terms of how they've benefited from the Cloud Foundation VCF and the Live Recovery VLR?
Yeah, so the business objective is to actually get confident recovery back, right? Because if you get hit by ransomware, you have two choices, pay up. If you can't recover, you pay up, or you're gonna recover. So how can we help our customers recover? And also, when you get hit by ransomware, there are multiple problems to think about. Like you have all these, you need a clean room, you gotta set it up. You need to kind of think about cost effective from a business perspective. So we offer you a choice. The clean room can be, you can build it on your data center. We have that option if you wanted to. Or also, we have an option to do dynamically kind of use cloud resources when you have a problem. You don't have to pay all the time. You can just pay when you need to. So there are different options we provided from a business perspective to actually get value from that. And then secondly, it's about the downtime you have for your business. Like how long does it take to recover? We kind of really worked hard on making sure that, like for example, we've done some integration with vSAN as a storage system so that it's a 10x faster to recover from like some of the problems you have, and how do you bring it data back? And so it's about TCO, like how do we save money for the customer? Ultimately, it's a DIY kit. If you do not follow a guided workflow tool, you're doing it all yourself. And that's a danger for every company. Everybody's inventing, like you have to discover every customer what you're going to do when you get hit by this problem. And secondly, how do you test this frequently? So those are the things we have done to actually kind of help the customers, like agility in terms of like reduce risk and cut costs so that you get a solution. It's like iPhone solution as opposed to just a bunch of like tools here and there to gonna put it together.
Right, so operational efficiency, integration, definitely a great ecosystem to make the teamwork happen. And you're right, you can't invent cyber resilience or determine what your cyber resiliency tolerance is when you just got hit. It's too late, way too late. Let's talk about, so you mentioned clean room. I think it's a great concept. Just double click on this for me, if you don't mind, for our viewers. What do you mean by clean room? How do you implement it?
Yeah. So the clean room, what we mean by that is that if we want to be able to launch some of the infected VMs there, we do not know what happened, are they good, bad, but we want to launch them. But if you launch them, you need a place where you can control the network around it, so you can quarantine those VMs. The problem is if you don't quarantine the VMs, they escape, and then you can get this lateral problem, fundamental, right? You're back to where you were before. So VCF, VMware Cloud Foundation, has a built-in tools and toolkits. Like, for example, we have something called VPCs. It's a virtual private cloud, but it's a networking construct. And it's all programmatically done. So we can control the network, you know, dynamically control so that a given set of workloads do not escape and they kind of firewalled out. And also there are different kinds of settings in this VPC so that you can allow some traffic. Sometimes, you know, you want to allow some traffic because they may talk to something and come back and say, okay, I'm doing something. So you need these different variations in the networking connectivity. It's very sophisticated. And that's why I think it's very hard to do this by hand. You got to do this programmatically and be able to like dynamically change the attributes to see, learn behaviorally what this ransomware is doing and come back with the recipe saying, okay, this is the problem, let's fix it.
Yeah, I think this is the most important part of the conversation here, what you just said, because you have to set it up, there will be variations, and really practice makes perfect, and you have to be ready and trained, and the way to do this is to leverage a clean room type environment, fully contained, but with the ability to really observe what's happening so you can really prepare for various scenarios in terms of recoverability. It brings up maybe a final question on, you know, everybody talks about AI and Gen AI and ML. How do you've been doing ML for a long time. So how do you introduce now new capabilities? What are you thinking about directionally? And, you know, I'm just curious about that.
Yeah. So this network traffic analysis, already we do ML because we have to look at behavior patterns. It's not so much just looking at some signature, it's actually detecting behavior, like what are they doing? How are they extracting data out, like other. So that's kind of very ML-based stuff. But beyond that, if you get hit by something, like then you detect there's a problem. The question then, we've done some amount of work on this space with the Gen AI stuff, it's called Intelligent Assist. And the idea is that it'll walk you through, like step by step, here's the problems you hit by, and kind of, because sometimes the number of errors you get from these false positives, false error alerts is so many, so much. So it's about how do we reduce that? How do we help customers navigate that and kind of give them a menu of options when there's a problem, here's a problem, and also then they can get choices how to remediate it. So those are the steps we're guiding the customer through, and each problem is a little different. So GenAI really helps us kind of actually navigate this space and actually be able to help customers understand and remediate.
Great conversation. I mean, I'm sure we'll hear more about your capabilities around AI, GenAI, but fundamentally, a fully integrated stack on VMware Cloud Foundation, augmented by the live recovery component and the great set of integrations. Sazzala, thank you so much for joining us today and for giving us all these details.
Thanks, Christopher. Thanks for being for calling me over here. A lot of other things we're doing, cool stuff. I'm happy to share later.
Thank you. And to our viewers, thank you so much for joining us today. My name is Christophe Bertrand, Principal Analyst here at theCUBE Research. See you on the next one.